I have received a transmission. It is Professor Gwen Kahn.
Professor Kahn? Oh yeah, is it in real time?
The transmission is direct from the station.
Oh my, hello. I've been waiting for you, gentlemen. Yes, I had a feeling that you might stop here.
All right, Kahn. What are you doing here?
I could ask you the same thing. I went to great lengths. Finally, I caught up with you. It wasn't easy, let me tell you.
Why does he follow us, and how does he keep finding out where we are?
Good question. Did you plant a transmitter on us, or what?
Oh my. How did you know that?
What do you mean?
I planted a bug. Oh, well, it's not exactly a bug, but it's something like a bug, right? It was back in the planning stages for the XGP. Since the planning stages. But I devised it so that no one would know about it but me.
Wait a minute. What do you mean, back in the planning stages?
Forget about that. I have found someone who knows the coordinates of the galactic ley line. I actually found someone. Go ask the man yourself. The thing is, he's currently incarcerated at Gehenna Prison. Apparently, he's been sentenced to 300 years, and he's not allowed visitors. But you need to go there and ask him what the coordinates are, Gene. Yes, yes, you do.
What the hell are you babbling about? There's no way in hell I'm going into any prison.
But Gene, he actually knows what the coordinates are.
There's gotta be somebody else besides him who knows the damn coordinates.
Yes, but understand, Gene, those somebodies are high-ranking K-pirates, and I really don't want to get involved with them. I simply can't get involved with them.
Then I'll get involved. I prefer not to listen to that fishy story of yours, otherwise I might find myself drowning somewhere. Gilliam, prepare to launch.
Already? But we just got here.
Wait a moment, are you crazy?
I've already made up my mind. All this time we've stayed away from the K territory, doing nothing but avoiding it. Now I'm gonna go there and make them tell us the secret of the galactic ley line.
No, you mustn't, you fool. Listen to me.
Forget it.
Melvina, listen. Ley line project command input. It was you who broke my Mason plate.
Melvina?
I was the one who created her control system and commands from the beginning. I have now suspended her personality.
What the hell do you think you're doing? Turn her back to normal now!
Oh, I will. Don't worry. Once you go to the prison, meet with the man and find out the Galactic Ley Line's coordinates.
You bastard! You mean planet Hecaton Kyres?
Yes, that's right. It's a strange world that's very massive for an Earth-type planet. It has an incredibly high rotational speed and a gravity of 1G along its equator. It's shaped like an intricate string of beads on an abacus.
Hey, Gilliam!
Yes, just a moment. I'll pull up the data.
What's an abacus anyway?
The point is, it's not the shape that's the problem, it's the gravity. The force pushing down on the planet varies depending upon where you are. It's a crushing 10.4 Gs at the poles, even though it's still 3 Gs where the prison is situated.
Then I guess you'd weigh 3 times what you normally would.
That's right, Jim. What a smart boy to figure that out so quick. At any rate, there isn't a single area in the prison where the gravity is stabilized. As a matter of fact, for security reasons, you can't find a gravity-stabilized area anywhere on the entire planet. Due to its high rotational speed, the whole planet acts as a huge dynamo, generating a powerful magnetic field around the globe. The result is that radios and radar don't transmit or receive as well on the surface.
And in human time, one day is 74 minutes. Just thinking about it makes me sick.
I didn't realize that Gehenna Prison is on Hecaton Kyres. No wonder why no one has ever gotten out alive. Gene, you've got to be careful. Your usual recklessness won't serve you well if you want to take on this mission.
She's right. Use your head this time. If you jump in without thinking, it's all over.
Yeah, like you're one to talk.
Gene, come on.
You say that no one's ever gotten out of there alive, huh? All right, then. What are we waiting for? Where are Suzuka and Aisha?
Just like you said, Aisha's with Mel, and Suzuka's sticking to Gwen Kahn like glue.
All right, Jim, now, don't let your guard down. Kahn, did you get a chance to look into what I was asking you for?
Yes. As a matter of fact, I've got it right here with me, a monopole. I don't know what you're going to use it for, but bear in mind that it's even more expensive and more rare than Dragonite, so make sure you return it to me when you're finished using it.
Yeah, sure, I got it. I understand what you're saying. So anyway, were you able to rig it like we discussed?
Of course, I camouflaged it well, if I do say so myself. It's an incredible piece of work that would cost a small fortune if it was made by someone else.
If you do say so yourself. See you later, Jim. I'm counting on you.
Yes, sir!